I'm Sarah from Spark, and in this video, I'm going to take you through the Stripo plugin that was developed for use in visual dialogue.
So the Stripo plugin was developed so that you could create your emails or design your emails in Stripo and then have them distributed through visual dialogue. So that way you get all the design capabilities of Stripo while still getting all the data capabilities and marketing automation of visual dialogue. So let's go and create our first email in Stripo, or first login. Now, if you're logging in for the first time, you might notice at the top section here, you may be in your personal account. You need to change that over to shared and then select your company in order to be able to see all the email templates that's associated to your organization. From here, we click on new email. When you're creating a new email, you can choose from some saved templates you may have, some basic templates that Stripo has set up, and also a ton of other sample templates that Stripo have available to you. For now, I'm just going to go with one of our saved templates to start. Okay, first thing, let's give our email a name and click save. Okay, from here, you can go ahead and edit your email, add in any images, text. It's very easy, drop and drag. I won't go through it in this video, just because there are a ton of articles out there that you can check out to get some good design tips for your Stripo emails. Once you've finished editing your email, you can send yourself a tester. You do that in the top little circle up here with a clipboard and a tick. Just punch in the email address you want to send it to. You can do a few tests if you've got some other colleagues, but just one email address at a time can be sent. So let's assume you have finished editing your email now and you have checked the test. Everything is good to go. The last step in Stripo you need to do for now is save this email as a template. So we do that up here. At the moment, it's just an email. We're going to click the drop-down box, go to save as a new template. Okay, you can see the little notification down here says that it's done. So what this does, I'll show you, we'll go back to the menu, is it has now saved our email we were working on as a template, not just an email. So this is really important because the plugin for visual dialogue will only be able to pull back the information or the templates that are saved as a template. Okay, we're done with Stripo for now, so let's log into Visual Dialogue so that we can distribute that Stripo created email. All right, we are now in Visual Dialogue. The first thing we need to do is set up what we have called a shell template, a shell email template. Essentially, all it is a blank email that Visual Dialogue uses to populate the contents of the Stripo created email that we just made. So let's go create message template. There are a few different ways you can create a message template. This is just the way I do it. Give it a name. Make sure it's a HTML email. Click finish. Now the settings of this shell template is what Visual Dialogue will record in things like customer view, any reporting. It's also what will be used, like the information in this control parameters section will be used to pick up the recipient info, who the email has been sent by, and also the subject line. So it doesn't matter what subject line you put in your Stripo email in Stripo, it'll still pick up the subject line that you put in this shell template. So let's go ahead and fill out the control parameters. I'm just going to put my email address for the to address for now. When you're ready to go, it will be a data merge tag for the email address of your customer and a subject line. Now, the bottom section of the email, the shell template, you need to leave blank. This is what will be filled with the Stripo content. The only other thing to note with this shell template is that the outbox properties, so we'll go up to properties, advanced, the outbox checkbox, if that is checked, then the emails will be created, but they will be stuck in your outbox. So depending on what you want, you'll just need to remember that that is as a default checked. I'm going to uncheck it and click save. Okay, now we've got our shell template. Let's put it into a dialogue. create dialogue. And we're going to get our Stripo email operation and pop it in there. So let's assume we've popped the selection, our target customers there. And now I just want to learn how to configure the Stripo operation. So we'll double click on that operation and let's go through it. So the top section, you don't need to do anything to this. The Stripo template section, this will connect live to the templates that are saved in your Stripo account project. So then you just find the email that you are working on or the template that you are working on and pop it in there. So this will update live. So if you have any changes that are made in Stripo, they will immediately reflect here as well without you needing to update anything here. Email template. Here is where you enter the shell template that we just created. Okay, you'll notice that the default is to check for blocking category. This is for people that have previously unsubscribed. So just to note, that is checked. Whether you want to keep it or not is up to you. Click is active to activate the branch. I won't give it any sort of execute options for now. And there we go. Click OK. So that is a completely configured Stripo operation. And that's all done. So any participants that are moving through this operation will be sent the shell template, which is merged with the content from the Stripo template that we created earlier. I forgot to mention this when I was recording the video, but just to note, this operation will merge the template in Stripo as it is saved at that very second that the operation in Visual Dialog is executing. So for example, if you schedule your dialogue to say run tomorrow and the Stripo operation is also running tomorrow, but no participants have actually gone through the Stripo operation just yet, then you have until right before the Stripo operation executes to make any updates that you might need to make to your Stripo template. And that's about it. But before you go ahead and start using the Stripo plugin, I would really recommend getting your head around the use of data merge tags. So those are the data fields that you can insert into your Stripo email. I'll quickly jump in to show you. Okay, we're back in Stripo now. Open up the template, and the data merge fields are things like this here. Those funny little arrows on either side. You might also have one to personalize the email in the salutation. You might have more specific information within the email as well. So merge tags, and also to get a good understanding of how to track the links that are in your email, and that's done in the code of Stripo in Stripo as well. That's really important if you want or you're hoping to do any follow-up activity based on how a person engages with the email. So if they've clicked a link, requested a demo, so how to track hyperlinks within your email. So if you need more information on that, you can check out the Spark YouTube channel or just get in contact with your Spark account manager. Good luck and thanks for watching.